Hey, how you doing? I'm just reading through some comments and a lot of people asking about their on-prem domains and how to extend that into Azure using things like hybrid domains and Azure AD domain services. So I think we need to get one thing straight.
I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy.
So the first thing we need to do is take these three separate things and we need to give a basic understanding of what they are and how they work. Now, you've been using Active Directory for near on forever at this point, but your key value propositions out of Active Directory is NTLM and Kerberos authentication, group policy management, LDAP, DNS resolution, all that good stuff. Even though we call it Azure Active Directory, it's not an Active Directory in the same sense as AD is, meaning that it's not a directory structure, there's no hierarchy, there's no OUs. That stuff just isn't there today. It's also not based on NTLM and Kerberos auth. This uses OAuth and SAML. There's no GPOs, and it's really there as an identity service. So in that sense, they are the same thing because AD was our identity service on-prem. Azure AD is the identity provider in the cloud. Let's get to the hero of today's video. Azure AD Domain Services. Now, I have found that this service is extremely misunderstood in what it is, how it does, and how it works with AD and Azure AD. So what is Azure AD Domain Services? Well, it is a traditional type domain controller, but done as a cloud PaaS service. The beauty of that, unlike your regular domain controllers, you don't have to manage it. It pretty much just takes care of itself and provides for you NTLM, Kerberos, LDAP, DNS. And this is where the problem comes in, because most people, when they think about extending their Active Directory into the cloud, they're thinking about it traditionally, taking a domain controller that they have on-prem, that's got their domain, they have AD sites and services, and we're gonna put up another one in the cloud in a different Azure AD site called Azure. It's gonna have its own IP address range, and that's how you traditionally extend AD into Azure. Azure AD Domain Services is nothing like that whatsoever. Azure AD Domain Services is a completely separate, independent, Microsoft-managed forest and domain. It is not connected to your Active Directory in any way, shape, or form. It is not an extension of AD. It is not a different site in your AD forest. And what this means is that it is not an extension of your domain at all. Let me put it this way. It's kind of like if I have a domain called MS Azure Academy. Let's say that you also created in your own lab msazureacademy.com as a domain. Now, can you technically do this? Yes, you can. There's nothing stopping you. It's your lab, it's your domain controller. But when you put those things on the internet, now you're gonna have a problem, because all of the records globally resolve to me. But let's skip past that for a second and just think about it as my domain and your domain, and they're called the same thing. I cannot manage your domain. You can't manage my domain. That's what Azure AD Domain Services is. It's a completely independent Microsoft managed domain that may or may not have the same name as your own domain, but it's not yours to control. You are not an enterprise admin. You are not a domain admin, and you are most certainly not a schema admin. You have a little more rights than just a standard user, but not much. So with all these downsides, why in the world would you want to use this thing? Well, there are some very clear use cases. First would be if you don't have an on-prem Active Directory, but you still need NTLM and Kerberos. This is a great use case for that because you don't have to manage it. All you have to do is click the button and deploy it and then reap the benefits. It's also one of the ways you can implement Windows Virtual Desktop. It integrates very nicely with AD authentication to an Azure File Share. And like I mentioned before, it integrates very nicely with Azure AD. It's simply there so that you can do all of your legacy authentication in a modern authentication world. Speaking of authentication, let's talk about our users. You already know that you have Active Directory and you have a domain controller, which stay in sync using this lovely tool, Azure AD Connect. That's how your identities end up in the cloud and they have the same password that they have on-prem. So let's turn this whole thing for just a moment, and we're going to now look at the Azure AD Domain Services side of this equation. So we have now our users, let's say Batman, sitting up here in Azure. When we build Azure AD domain services, there is a managed Azure AD Connect sync that happens between Azure and Azure AD domain services. So Batman will sync over into the Azure AD DS domain. And therein lies the problem. Because when Batman ends up there, you will never be able to log in. Why? Because when Azure AD Connect does its magic and syncs our password hashes into Azure, they're not stored in a format that is NTLM Kerberos compatible. So sorry, Batman, but you don't have a password. And this same thing happens to your administrators in your Azure AD DS domain. In order to log in, you have to force a password reset, which you can just do on demand, or set an expiration for your password so that people have to go in and change them. When the passwords are reset, now we will have a hash that we can sync over to Azure AD domain services, and now you can log in.
If you want to master the Azure cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
So let's set up Azure AD domain services. Here we are in my Azure Active Directory. You can see that I've got Azure AD Connect already syncing, and I am a global administrator. So I'll start by going to the global search up there at the very top, and we'll type in domain services, and we'll click on Azure AD domain services. And once we get to this blade, we'll just click to add a new instance of Azure AD domain services. And first thing, of course, we need is a subscription and resource group. And now we have our domain name. Now you can leave it as your exact domain name matching what you already have on-prem and in Azure AD, but just to keep it simple, I'm gonna make my domain aadds.msazureacademy.com. No matter what we call it, there's still two completely separate independent forests. So the next thing, of course, is our region, and you want something as close to the rest of your stuff as possible. And then we have our SKU. You can click on the link way over there to find out more about each SKU and what they offer. To sum it up from a technical standpoint, standard is just normal Azure AD domain services, whereas premium and enterprise will give you the option for adding a resource domain, which is the next button below it. And we hit next, and this is where we set up our network. At the very top, it of course suggests a new network for this, and you can do that if you want to. But I want to show you some other options. If you have an existing network or subnet that you want this to use, and I've got two of them here, one labeled bad and one good. If I click on the bad one, you see that we've got red all over the place because it's not in a IP address range that Azure AD Domain Services requires. And then if we go back and select good, because it is in a good range, we are good to go. So we'll hit next. Next, we have the administration tab, and here's where we're going to set up a new group in Azure AD that is called AADDC Administrators. So that's our admin group for Azure AD Domain Services, even though you're not like a domain admin like I mentioned earlier. And if you click on the link here to manage your group membership, and then at the top here, you can select the add members, and then up here, you can select, just like a standard user picker, whatever group or user membership you want to add. And then the next section here is for notifications. I suggest leaving those alone, but you can do whatever you like here. Now we're on the synchronization tab. By default, it's going to sync everything, that is every user and group in your Azure Active Directory. If you want something different, you can just change the tab here to scoped, and then right under that, you have a synchronization scope. Just click to select which groups you want to add. I'm okay with syncing all of my users and groups, so I'll just change that back to all, and we'll click next. And then Azure is going to go ahead and validate everything that we have just selected, and then your create button will be highlighted. When you click on it, now we're going to get this little pop-up because there's a few things you need to know. And this is just telling you that you better be really sure that these settings are all okay, because none of these items are going to be able to be changed once you spin this up. Of course, you could always delete it and reprovision if you needed to. But we'll click OK to that, and then like any other resource, it is going to provision. So when it's all done, you'll see this screen where Azure AD is now reporting healthy. But we're not done yet. There's a couple other things we have to set up. So we have to now configure our DNS settings just like a standard domain controller. So if you scroll down just a little bit, you'll see a configure DNS button. And if you click that, It'll take care of doing all that for you. And the way it does it is by taking the virtual network where your Azure AD Domain Services VMs are set up and just configures that to use custom DNS pointing directly at our two new domain controllers that are part of our service. Now we have to get our users configured. So just below that, you can see a link that we'll right click on and open in a new tab. And this is how we can get our password hashes in Azure AD to go over into Azure AD Domain Services. And we're going to use our Azure AD Connect in order to make this happen. So if you scroll down here to the Enable Synchronization for Password Hashes section, click the copy button, and now we'll pop over to the server where I have Azure AD Connect installed and we'll open up PowerShell. Copy in your code and open Azure AD Connect. So at the top, we'll go to the connectors tab, and then you want to select on the first connector, and that will have a type of Windows Azure Active Directory. And then we want to copy the name exactly because we'll need that for PowerShell. At the very top, we've got a variable, and then we'll plop that right into the first variable. Go back into Azure AD Connect, take our second connector, which should be the type of Active Directory Domain Services, do an exact copy of the name again, back to PowerShell, and paste it as our second variable. And then what I like to do is to run that section just at the top with the import module commands, just so I get that stuff out of the way. Followed briefly by selecting the rest of the code and then running that as a separate command. Now we'll pop over back into Azure Active Directory and go to our groups because we have a new group, the Azure AD DC Administrators. And if we go there and go to our members, there's the people that we assigned. Now let me go to Superman and do a password reset, but we've got a problem. We cannot do a password reset because in order to do that, we need to have password write back enabled. So back to our domain controller, and we'll open up the Azure AD Connect tool so we can configure it. Once it's open, click configure. And then we want to click on the customize synchronization options and then hit next. Put in the appropriate username and password, click next. And on the Connect Your Directories screen, we'll just click Next there, as well as the Domain and OU filtering. And here in the optional features is where you'll find that little checkbox for password writeback. Now, what is that going to do? We've already set up the password hash synchronization with our PowerShell from Azure into Azure AD Domain Services. This is going to go the other way. Now we've got password changes that'll happen in the cloud in Azure, and that will be synchronized back to our domain controllers, whether on-prem or in the cloud. So we'll click Next. And on the single sign-on screen, you could already have that enabled or not, doesn't matter, just click Next. And then you can go ahead and click Configure to finish everything out. And when you're done, just hit the Exit button. Now we're back in Azure, we can finally click on that Reset Password button, and Azure will now let us do that. So I'll put in a temporary password of Change Me, and then we will go to a private browsing window and log in with Superman. We'll provide Change Me as my current password, as well as a new password, and we are logged in. So now that our users are done, let's take a look around Azure AD Domain Services and see what we've got. So I've got two different Azure AD users and computers open. Over on the left is Azure AD Domain Services, and on the right is my traditional domain controller. So right away, you can see that the OU structure is not the same at all. And you may be thinking, of course they're not the same. The domain names are different. But like I told you before, it doesn't matter whether it is exactly the same name as your current domain environment or a completely different name, or even one that appears like a subdomain name like mine does. They are completely separate independent forests. And looking over at the domain controllers container, you see, of course, that we have two different sets of domain controllers. And you can see that the sites are different as well. More about that in a second. But let me right click on an OU on both sides. And you can see on the right side where I am a domain admin, I've got the ability to create anything new that I want to. But even though I'm logged on the left with Superman, who is my Azure AD DC admin, I don't have the rights to create anything. If we looked at Active Directory sites and services, again, on the right, we have my traditional domain, and over there on the left, Azure AD Domain Services. and they are very different once again. And notice that the site from either one of them does not appear in the scope of the other. They are completely disconnected, separate, independent, no way are they ever going to talk to each other environments, and this is not an extension of my existing domain into Azure. And just to prove the point once and for all, I have rebuilt my Azure AD Domain Services environment, and it is now named exactly like my regular domain, msazureacademy.com. And as you can see, it is still a completely separate, independent domain and forest that is not communicating at all with my on-prem AD. It is only the user accounts that can be synced from one environment into the other. The two domains do not communicate at all. So I hope that this has cleared up for you the purpose of Azure AD Domain Services and how it can benefit you as you're building out something like Windows Virtual Desktop or integrating with Azure Files or any other Azure AD application that requires NTLM and Kerberos. And keep an eye out for some future videos on hybrid join as well as Azure AD join in getting us prepared for Windows Virtual Desktop being able to use those features. So make sure that you click subscribe, like, comment, share, all the buttons that are doing all the good stuff. And you want to check out our latest video right over there so that you can be sure to stay on top of everything going on in Azure, as well as this one right down here that the YouTube machine overlords have picked out just for you. And we will catch you next time. Happy learning.